Hello, so this will be a very in-depth guide about mining in general and about mining iron and some other stuff as well. But if you just want the short version, the route is something like this over here, and over here there is another one. And also you'll find another one a bit to the left over here. Or you can just have one here, one here, one here, and then you go over here. There are two or three over here, over there, over there. And then you just go over here, which are the biggest nodes are over there, and then you can go over there, and then you have one over here, which is the sneaky one, but is also a big one. So that's the short route. Actually, that's the long route. If you want to do the short route, you can just go from over here to the bear, I mean, one, two, three spots, four and five, and then you can just wait until it's done. But if you want to do the full route, it's something like this. So you go from over here, I'll show you, don't worry, over here, something like this, like that, and then you actually go around the place, get the node over here, and when you're coming back, you'll actually go on top of this thing because you'll have a lot of shock spires or whatever they are called, which will give you, of course, mining experience, air modes, and some other stuff as well, which is great, believe me. Then you can come back over here. Now, as I mentioned, it will be a more in-depth guide about mining and in general a lot of other stuff. So, oh, by the way, there are also a few shock bulbs around this place over here. Actually, over here there are a few shock bulbs. There are blueberries in the valley and also squash. Why am I saying this? Well, because as long as you're here, you might as well gather some other stuff. So there are resources in the valley. So what's the big deal about iron ore? Well, if you are actually a bit higher level, if you are level 35, then you should definitely get a Star Metal mining pickaxe. At this point, you should never mine when you have the time, unless you kind of are bored. Otherwise, mining is kind of like a 3 or 4 hour operation. If you do this right, you'll basically not need to mine for the entire week. So I recommend you just invest the hours to actually get all of the loot necessary to kind of make your life a lot easier, because for example, if you want to do it the right way, I really recommend you have a pickaxe, Star Metal pickaxe, with these things on. Prospector Discipline, 6.8 more mining experience. Really, really useful to get those few level ups faster. And also Mining Guild. Mining Guild's 50% more resources. And you can actually boost this a lot of ways. So you kind of have to wear your mining gear that is reinforced mining lock. So you should have a full set with items that have reinforced mining set or mining lock. Sadly, I don't have it right now because I was not really prepared and they cost a lot of money and I have to buy a house and make another video about buying the house. So yeah, Star Metal pickaxe with these ones, I don't know, you can take the azot one or the lock one if you feel like it, but usually you need quantity over here, not quality, at least for now. So if you find a pickaxe with also lock on it or mining luck, that will be a little better. But as it is, Mining Guild is super good. Prospector's Discipline is super good as well. So put your mining set on, and this is the trick. Use your roasted potatoes or whatever potatoes you have to increase your mining luck. And then this is where the catch is, something that people don't really do. If you are higher enough level, you can buy a cheap house. A cheap house is about 2,400, depends on where you buy it. If you have a house, it doesn't matter if it's cheap or expensive, you can also put down a trophy to increase your luck. Of course, you'll have to use the miner trophy, which is not an easy thing to do, and I still have to buy the house, like I said. Let me see where that one is. No, that's not the one. Ah, they look the same. They look very similar. So that's engineering. So where is the one that will give you mining? That's for the logging. This is the mining. So minor mining gathering trophy. So put this in your house as well. It helps a lot actually. And after you do all of this, you might think, well, that's enough. No, that's not enough. You also have to use the potions. Actually, the weak proficiency booster, I bought one for about 0.40 gold. So imagine that. You buy, let's say, 10 of these for 4 gold, and that increases your yield by 5%. Additionally to the bonuses you get from your mining set, which I don't have right now, mining luck, of course, additionally from the roasted potatoes, from the trophy and some other stuff as well. Also, keep in mind, when you are smelting the iron ore, if you make it to steel, use the better one, because if you use the shell dust flux, you can basically make, you can almost double your quantity of bars, which is also great. So try to use the higher yield resources as well. Also, well, let's just keep it at this. Now, why is this zone so important for me? Well, for example, okay, if you're level 45, that's even better because you have 3 bags, as you can see. Prospector's burden reduces the weight of ores, ingots, and pickaxes by 8.5. Also, we have these ones over here. Sadly, you kind of need Prospector's burden 3 times, I mean, on all 3 bags if you really want to do a lot of good work. And that means you'll have about 1000 carry capacity, and the items will weigh 25% less. The ores will weigh 25% less, so that's actually a lot of ore. So you might be thinking, okay, so is it this overkill? No, it's not. So why do I prefer this area? Simply put, it's close to 3 settlements. So when you are full of mining ores, probably the first time you'll go into Weaver's Fan Village, deposit all of it, come back over here, get full on iron ores again. Go to Brightwood, come back, get full on iron ores, deposit over here again. And then, when you have the time or you feel like it, you can actually smelt it into iron bars. Again, it depends to you and on a lot of other things. But generally, you want to do this as much as possible. So, let's see. Increase your luck. Let's drink another one. Actually, I didn't drink it yet. So let's see the yield. The yield for the big nodes is between 38 and 52 for me, so they can vary between 20% less or 20% more. So that's actually a pretty big difference if you ask me, so let's see how much I get for this big one now. 52 iron ore, plus the onyx, plus the fey iron, and plus the other things. By the way, as a small node, you see this fey iron over here? I never got a single piece of fey iron while mining normally. So that means a couple of things. The roasted potatoes are actually a huge buff, and the other items are also big buffs. So 52 mining iron ore. Usually I got about 44. Oh, that's a lot. Okay, so this is the start of the route. Now I have to go back over here again. You can mix and match, or you can use the short version if you like. But usually I like to do the full one because, well, you'll get bored. You'll get very bored because the iron ore actually spawns slower than your mining or slower than your movement speed. So the big nodes are actually spawn around 15 minutes or 10 and 15 minutes. So at some point you'll just outmine everything. We have 2 nodes over here. Again, these are kind of optional, but you know, my opinion is when you're mining, you should mine all the time. If you're not getting the big nodes, that's okay, you'll get the smaller ones and you'll also get the experience. I think this is where people are doing it a bit wrong. I think they just want to get the big nodes and then they want to forget about it, but no, it doesn't work like that. Also, you can go on top and continue your way, but I just like to go over here. Oh, actually, no, I forgot something. Now I have to climb back over here. Weirdly enough, this is a very weird jump. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't work. Okay, we made it. So, I think what most people do it wrong is that they expect to mine only the big iron ores. And you know what? If you just mine all the big ones, it's okay. But if you mine 2 or 3 smaller ones, you can actually get sometimes, well, if you mine 3 smaller ones, you'll get the same amount of ore as a big one. So, don't fight for the big ones, mine the small ones as well. And actually, that's a medium one, so we have small, medium and big. Also, when you see the big ones, I recommend you mine them first, because they spawn slower, so yeah, it's a good idea to mine the big ones first, so you kind of get ahead of the spawning cycle. And believe me, all of these bonuses I mentioned will add up like crazy. If you're doing this for 1 hour, you'll basically fill your inventory. 1 hour of doing this will fill your inventory with about 5,000 iron ore. Again, it depends on your bag, but usually I can hold about 5,000 ores with my current bags. And, well, you kind of need to come here with your inventory empty. So I'm a big believer in optimizing stuff. And believe me, you can optimize this even more, like I said. But I don't think it's really worth it unless you really want to invest in this. So I don't recommend you do mass gathering until you reach level 45 and you have 3 bags and you also have a good amount of tools, a good set of tools and a sharp mind. You can kill the bear, he's not too hard to kill, he's level 30 and you can mine him for motes, level 4 motes. Earth Quintessence. As you can see, this one over here is already mined. Not a problem, we'll take the smaller ones because they spawn faster, like I said. I already started with iron ore, but I guess you can see we'll get about 400-500. Also, people tend to miss the one below us. And there is also a smaller one over there, and there is the one over here. So this is a route that people usually don't do because, well, it's a little out of their way, and usually people come here to go to other places. As you can see, it's not in the main roads of anywhere. Otherwise, you can pretty much do this route over here, or you can also do this route over here, but it's not as good, and people will always kind of walk between those areas and, you know, casually mine some iron because they're in the area. Sorry if I'm talking too much or explaining too much, but like I said, I just like everything to be a little more optimized. So you can actually make, I think I got about 600 steel bars in how much time? In about 3 hours. So 600 steel bars in about 3 hours. And again, I can optimize this even further. And I didn't even use the proficiency potion. And I don't even have the... Okay, eh. Let's just leave it at this. I don't even have all of the items, like I mentioned. I guess we have a straggler with us. Those are up, that's nice. Also, I like this area because it's not as annoying as some of the other areas. For example, it doesn't have a lot of rain. It doesn't have a lot of... Well, it has fog now, but usually doesn't have this much. Okay, there are the 3 iron nodes over here, but I guess if you get one, that's good enough for me. Because, like I said, it's all about repetition, it's all about doing this a few times and kind of learning the layout. Now, if you get over here and if you mine the other one, you can see the other big one down there. I hear footsteps. No, he'll get... Oh, it's only the turkey, it's not a person. Also, I'll do this route 2 times, and in case you're wondering why, it's not because I want to show people to watch my videos for 20 minutes, it's because I just want to show you the respawn times and how fast it can be done. So you can actually program a few breaks in between. But usually if you do it right, you don't have any time for breaks. Over there, there is the next nodes. There are the next nodes. Hey, gather that one. So this is pretty good for mining experience as well, because... Well, you might say, well, isn't star metal faster? No, star metal takes a very, very long time to... Oh, okay, that's bad. Takes a very, very long time to mine. So that's 1 and 2, and that's 3. Yeah, like I said, it's all about getting at least a little bit of iron. So if you are fighting with other people over the spots, that's not good in my opinion. And as you can see on this route, you'll always get a little bit of iron. So it doesn't matter if there are 2 or 3 people doing the same route. Well, I recommend you do it when no one else is doing it, but you'll still get a bit of iron here and there. Anyway, the idea is that you'll never leave empty-handed or you'll never get frustrated on the fact that some people will just, you know, mine a lot more than you. Besides, you can also collect some other resources on the way, like I said, like the moats, like the shock stones, blueberries, some squash here and there, the mushrooms. Also, the great axe really helps with the dash skill. Yeah. Oh. This one is here. Okay, so let's see. If it goes beyond 50 iron ore, that's actually great. Because I want to see the max I can get with... 39. That's such a big letdown. So yeah, later in the game, You'll actually be doing a lot less working because of these things. Like I said, you have to work smarter, not harder. If you make mining trips, I mean, if you mine stuff for 2 or 3 hours and you don't have the buffs, you don't have the house, you don't have the bags with the prospector. What is it called again? With no prospector's burden. That means you'll not be able to carry a lot. And remember, you'll actually lose a lot more time just doing the trips than actually mining. And that, in my opinion, is kind of like a waste of time. So yeah, probably if you have a good mining set, a full mining set, if you have a star metal pickaxe like I have, or even better, if you use a better proficiency potion, because this is a weak one. This is not even the good one. Like I said, it costs below 1 gold. The normal ones actually will increase your yield by about 7%, or I forgot the exact numbers, but by the time you actually reach it, you should be able to craft it yourself. So if you craft everything yourself, you'll basically be able to cut in half the amount of time you need to farm resources. And again, you can do this for all of the other resources. For example, for skinning, you just skin the animals with your skinner set equipped, and then you just go back with your tanner set and also your better resources, because don't, if you are at a higher level, don't ever use the lower quality refining agents. Just use the level, the tier 4 ones. I forgot the exact recipe for the proficiency boosting stuff, but it's 2 modes. Okay, that iron, big iron vein is ready over there. Besides, when I actually was doing this route kind of early, I was actually below 100 mining, but now yeah, we can take advantage of this. Like, this is why I like this. Oh yeah, even those ones have spawned. Okay, we'll have to go back. I didn't notice those ones because I was busy talking. Wait. I just have to focus more. Wow. I guess we're kind of like on the back trail of another guy that did the route and now he's actually in another place or just left. Yeah, so like I said, I think the full route, if you get all of the mining nodes with decent gear and what I had, it's about 600 iron ore in 10 minutes or less. Less time or less iron ore, depends on you. Yeah, so we got the one below. Also, you can check your times, your buffs from time to time. For example, let's eat some more potatoes. I mean, you will find a lot of food and you will find a lot of stuff that will help you along the way. So use everything you can. Look at that. Cloud amethyst, small quartz crystals. I'm pretty sure if I hadn't eaten the potatoes, I wouldn't have gotten those. So yeah, while you're doing this route, you can just take the way back. On your way back, you can go on the upper side to get those modes, and you can actually look at the iron nodes. If they respawn, just jump down. Yeah, I don't know. The game is fun, but I think you need to be very, very organized. Otherwise, you'll farm for hours and not get a lot of stuff. For example, if you are trying to farm 600 steel bars at a lower level, I think you'll need an entire day to make those, but over here, like I said, it was only a couple of hours. Okay, careful now. Also, I need a lot of mods for a lot of crafting. And the funny thing is that this potion is actually in engineering, so yeah, it's not under Arcana like you'd expect, it's under engineering, so yeah. You will need to craft a lot of those potions, so that basically means you will raise your engineering skill and maybe even your food, your cooking, and maybe even your arcana. Depends on how you play the game and what buffs do you prefer. This was a nice one. I'll probably do this until my inventory is full and then I'll go and smelt it. As you can see, I'm getting a lot of experience and also my yield is norm is much bigger than usually. I guess we have time to kill Mr. Bear over here so we can see what happens or how strong he is. I mean, you don't have to fight him. By the way, this axe is not my main weapon. Yeah, he just looks at us very creepy. He says, "Oh, you killed a bear. Congratulations, you destroy nature." So this is one of the Angry Earth faction monsters. Quintessence and lodestone. Again, I'll not get into those elements, but let's just see the rest of the route for now. And yeah, like I said, it's worth it to bring those potions with you because it's below 1 gold. On your server, it might be a little more expensive. You can even craft them yourself. But to craft them, you need a lot of mods, and if you don't have them stockpiled, it can be a little tricky to get them. But usually in this game, everything is connected. If you have a few skills, they will help you increase your other skills, or they will help you farm less. Okay, that's enough. So that's kind of like the whole point of the video, and by now you probably know how to do the route, but I'll just do it one more time, so we'll see what can we get. We'll probably not get any iron ores or any of the big ones because, well, they have not respawned, they need more time. But you'll most likely do it so you can see the route again. I think to kind of remember something, you need to do it twice. Come on, I was already... I just had to give it a little bump. Also, it was important for me to not get bored while doing this, because if I would get bored, I will not do it anymore. So over here we have 6-8 nodes. So the total route is 26 nodes. Yeah, that big one didn't spawn. But usually you can just collect these ones and then go back for the other ones in the back. And that's the fun part. Now about the game in general. Well, I think this is kind of like banter section. I think the game has some really good things going for it, but at the same time I think it's one of those games where you basically have 95% useless items, and by that I mean potions, crafting and a lot of other stuff, armors, crafting, potions. And only 5% of whatever you do or pick up is actually important. Okay, this one is over here. It's a little trickier to see during the night. So yeah, everything you make will be kind of bad. So you need to make a lot of it and you need to have high levels everywhere. Otherwise, you will not have a fun time. Did I collect those? Probably I collected them and I forgot. This is the start, okay. So we have 8 nodes over here. Our potatoes are still going strong. Our boosting potion is still going strong. 25 iron ore, okay, that's actually one of the higher rolls. Let's see if we can get higher than 55 or something. Oh, a gate or leather satchel. Actually, I didn't see how much we got, but it was probably a good amount. And besides, we are actually moving, we are doing stuff, so if you want to take a break, you can take a break, there are no enemies. And like I said, there are a lot of other places, there are better places to mine iron ore. For example, Everfall is a lot better. Not Everfall, even Everfall is actually a lot better, but Monarch's Bluff, First Light I think is the best one for iron ore. All of the starter maps have a lot of iron ore, but a lot of people are there and... Well, I guess you will not really like the competition, because the competition can be very bad for your sanity. Let's see if any of them have respawned over here. Yeah, the minion one has respawned. That's nice. Venison stroganoff recipe. Interesting. Yeah, I guess the problem with the game is that they kind of undertone the game. So like I said, you need to do a lot of everything, and if you don't play it smart, you'll basically be stuck in an infinite loop of crafting, collecting resources and questing. So yeah, I've basically been only questing until I was kind of high level, so I had the bags, and now I can just craft and gather resources because I have the levels. But yeah, unless you really dedicate 100 hours, you cannot really go anywhere in this game, which is probably one of the bigger problems of the game. 100 hours to go anywhere in the game. Hey, not even Mr. Bear has respawned. Okay, only one. Okay, that's not a problem. I mean, probably the smartest thing for me to do right now would be to take a 10-minute break just eating or going outside or doing something else until all of the iron ore spawn. Because right now we're not really doing the efficient route, we are missing a few big nodes because of their spawn rate. Ah, that's no problem, like I said, you'll get a lot of ore no matter what you do. Let's see how much we got. I'm not sure how much I had, but we probably got 1,000 iron ore in about 20 minutes. Again, 6 minutes or kind of me explaining some stuff, so yeah, about 1,000 iron ore per 20 minutes. So yeah, that's actually a lot faster than I thought, so let me think about it. So yeah, about 4,000 iron ore per hour, which is not bad, not bad at all. Yeah, those things haven't respawned, they'll probably take a while to respawn. Yeah, just take a little break and do the full route, don't do it like me. This is basically about 75% of the route. Hey, that was spawned. The game took it away. I think we can do better than 51. You'll probably get this one on our way back, but again, the main point is if you don't want to wait or if you don't want to normalize the spawn rate, you can just go ahead and collect all of them because you're basically doing the same route. It doesn't matter that not all of the... Okay, you also have some hemp over there and some over there as well, if you really want to do something else. But the point is, if you just do this route, it doesn't really matter, because if you go back and forth... Just go back and forth like I showed you. It doesn't really matter if they're spawned or not, because you'll get some of them on your way forth and some of them will get on your way back. So yeah, it's a win-win situation no matter what you do. Now, the reason you should be doing this all at the same time, I mean you should wait for the spawns to normalize so you can get all of them at the same time, is because you might want to collect other resources along the way. For example, the blueberries like I showed you, the squash, maybe even kill a few turkeys. Otherwise, it's a very peaceful area to farm. I think we made a few levels in mining already. And the buffs last quite a long time, so we can basically get one full route in before they run out. And yeah, like I said, also you can gather a lot of hemp, you can get a lot of resources in these areas, because the amount of resources in this area is a bit more diverse than other ones. So moats, hemp, more moats from the plants, blueberries, that's food, turkeys, and a lot of other stuff as well if you just look around the place a little bit. I'm more interested in this one. No. Oh, it's over here, okay. And it really helps out. 49. It actually took my time to learn this sword because I didn't see it on a guide or anywhere. I just liked it and I made it possible. Okay, we'll actually go and wait for those other two to respawn and we'll see if we can get more than 55 iron ore out of them. And then I'll end the video because I think we have seen enough. But it was a fun time. It's a fun game if you really think hard about it and if you try to be organized, because without having the proper equipment or tools, you'll not get far. Also, I have a little bit of star metal. A dark magic essence. Fey iron. I think that's one of the fantastical, or the, how should you put it, the dark fantasy materials, Fey iron, that are commonly used in video games. Yeah, that one spawned. Oh yeah, that one spawned as well. So as you can see, we're doing the short route. And you can basically do it over here. Only over here and you'll get a lot of it. 51 iron ore. That's nice. Also, I want to see if the shockstone has respawned. Come over here, my little darling. Hmm, 43. Yeah, not as good. I think the developers need to work on these numbers. I mean, I like the numbers to be more variable, more flexible, but this can get ridiculous. So yeah, they have spawned. Sometimes, as you saw, if you'll get really unlucky on your rolls, you'll basically get 20% less materials per total. So sometimes you'll just have a bad day and there's nothing you can do about it. Okay, those have spawned as well. I mean, you should probably go and grab them, but I'll just grab some shock spars because I really want the modes. So I guess you can get quite a lot of these if you just stick with the route a little bit. And let's fly away. That's kind of a little buggy, but hey, I'm not complaining, the developers made it like that. So all is mine, the big one first. 55 iron ore, okay, that's actually very nice. You rarely see that amount of iron gathered from a big node. Onyx. And also the stones are nice, the other materials can be nice as well. Okay, he didn't actually mine that one. Normally I would go back on top of that and mine the rest, but since he didn't want to take that one, I'll just take it right now. And then I can go back and get the shock spires. Like I said, you can also kill the birds if you really want a lot more mining experience. There is also their nest over there. 44, that's actually kind of bad. So yeah, and also all the time when you get a tier 4 resource, that's actually super, super good. Hey, why do you mind? Yeah, sadly that's kind of it. You cannot go back over there. And that's the video. If you have any questions, you can ask. But otherwise, I think I mentioned 95% of the stuff you must do to have a better, or actually to have a shorter farming period, because farming will kill your mood for the game. Bye.